Okay, dear students, now we are back to our new session, geography. We have completed 3 lessons: representation of geographical features, the earth's major landforms, the earth's major water bodies. From last session onwards, we started our revision. Last session, we were discussing first lesson. We are doing the revision of a first lesson, representation of geographical features. We discussed last time what is maps, what is globe, what is a scale, difference between maps and globes. Then important features on the maps we started to discuss last time. Today we are going to discuss scale. Last time we while learning the lesson, we learned about scale. There are 2 types of scales are there. One is a large scale and another one is a smaller scale. Then large scale gives us more information, but at same time smaller scale gives us little information. Okay, then more detail we are getting from large scale, little details from smaller scale. And usually the smaller scale we use on globe and world map, such kinds of things. And a smaller scale we use as like a small maps. So small scale and large scale map. Okay, and here next thing it was important matter, it was a topographic map. Topographic map is a map showing both man-made and natural features. This we are getting, we are information of both type of features in topographic map. Then next thing, distance. Distance, finding distance that we used like a thread or a scale to find the distance. Then important thing, we have to know about the direction in order to know find out the particular place in particular area. There are 4 directions are there, like we can see what is it, north, south, east, west. Then northwest, northeast, southeast and southwest. Okay, these are the directions. Usually if there is no direction is showing or marked on the map, then usually we are taking top of the map as a north direction. And now let us go conventional symbols. We have learned conventional symbols. Then drawing or showing all the things on a map, it is impossible. So we are using some particular type of symbols, symbols on where maps to show to represent particular features. Okay, and these are the conventional, main conventional symbols. So I have asked you to learn figure number 1.6 so that you can be familiar with these symbols. Then key, what do you mean by key? The meaning of symbol used in a map are usually given in a list on the map are called key. So again, next one, it was a sketch. You know that a map shows the features of an area according to a scale. But sometimes we need rough drawing. Okay, here is the point, This is what sketch, a rough drawing of an area is a sketch. Then a plan. Plan is a detailed drawing. Usually we are making plan to construct a school or construct a building on such kinds of things. Okay. This we are drawing on large scale. Then we are going to diagram. A diagram is a simple drawing to show how something looks or how it is made or how it works. Okay, this is what the thing we learn from lesson number 1. Now let us go to lesson number 2. Here we learn mainly the earth's major landforms. Okay, that is what the heading of lesson number 2. Here we know crust. Earth has a solid surface made up of rocks and soil. That is what crust. Okay, uppermost layer of the earth is known as a crust. In we can say so 71% of crust are under the water and 29% are elevated above the sea level. Okay, in this 29% of a crust only we people are living. Okay, then usually we are taking what we are taking measurement from sea level. Okay, from sea level it is. Then landforms. The surface of the earth is not the same everywhere. Then some parts are elevated higher than the surrounding area. Again say so some of the parts they are elevated from the surrounding area, like this 29% they are known as landforms. Okay, how landforms are formed? Most landforms are formed by the process acting deep under the earth's surface. These processes are known as endogenous process. The action which take place under the earth, that is known as endogenous process. Because of this only, what happened? The landforms are getting formed. Then exogenous process. Next one, what is the exogenous process? The action is taking outside the earth, outside the upper part of crust is known as exogenous. Endogenous process, what? Because of endogenous process, the earth gets formed. Okay, only formation take place. Because of exogenous process, what happened? It gets shaped. Earth's form gets shaped. Now we are getting another thing. What is it? Mountains. One shape of the earth. A mountain is a conical mass of land rising. That is what? Mountain means what is it? It is a conical shape of land rising. Okay. Then next, valley. Valley means below the mountain, bottom of mountain, some plain area. This is known as valley. And mountain can be divided into three. One is a fold mountain, block mountain, and other things, volcanic mountains. These are the three types of mountains. First, we are going through the fold mountains. Then, because of folds, what happened? The sum of the part of earth is getting elevated. And that part, that is known as fold mountains. Okay, Fold mountains are formed when a part of Earth's surface is pushed up. It is getting pushed up from wrinkles called fold. The parts of wrinkles that are curved upward are called anticlines. Then the parts are that are curved downward are called cyclines. One is anticline, another one is cycline. Okay. Dear students, next day we will continue from here revision. So, have a nice day. Take care. Thank you.